Hi, today I'm going to be testing out a setting spray. I've actually never tested out setting sprays before, like I've never worn them. So this is my first time, first experience, and I'll be testing out a specific setting spray. It's called the NYX Matte Finish Long Lasting Setting Spray. So this is supposed to make your makeup last longer. And also if you do like face baking or if you wear a lot of powder, this is supposed to make your powder look less powdery and more like your normal skin. So I'm excited to see how this works, if it does indeed make my makeup last longer, make my skin more matte, and then also make the powder on my skin look a little bit less powdery and more like my normal skin. So without further ado, let's go ahead and give it a try because I'm so excited. I'm actually a little bit nervous too at the same time. I'm a nervous person, but this makes me a little bit nervous because I'm acne prone, like I have acne prone skin. So I hope this doesn't cause me any acne. If you've tried this before or have tried any setting sprays just in general, please let me know if you found that they cause you acne, because I do not want any more acne. I know it doesn't probably look like I have a lot of acne because I cover it up and I use a lot of like acne products, and I'm very cautious with my skin and make sure that like I don't have a lot of acne, but I actually have like a bunch of acne on my chest. Alright, so let's go ahead and give this a try. This is for oily skin, I'm assuming, because it's supposed to make your skin really matte but not powdery. And the instructions say, well, it has a lot of languages on it. Let me find English real quick. Mist face evenly, holding the bottle 10 to 12 inches from the face. So that's what I'll try to do. And the description for this product is, it's a lightweight water-based setting spray that keeps your makeup looking matte and amazing. Like literally amazing. Here. Alright, so without further ado, let me go ahead and start spraying it. So, I'm supposed to hold it 10 to 12 inches from my face. I think that's about the right distance, and okay, let's go ahead and give it a try. Oh man, it feels really weird to do this. I feel like swimming almost, because I don't usually have a bunch of water splashing in my face, and only my face. Like if I'm in the shower, that's a different story, because like I know I'm gonna be submerged into water. But like when your hair and makeup is done and you're all like dry and then you've got a bunch of water in your face, it feels really weird. Oh. Let me actually do one more spray this on this side. Oh. So, my skin doesn't look too much matter, but my powder is actually kind of disappearing into the skin, so that's a good thing. I mean, I guess my skin does look kind of matte. I guess it does, so I should take that back. It does look kind of matte. It doesn't really look matter than it did before, but it wasn't oily, so I don't think it can make my skin any more matte than it was before, because it was already pretty matte. And yeah, the powder does look like it's kind of blending into the skin more, so I really like that. Like I can't see any powder on my skin, like it doesn't look like I have any powder on. It just looks like I have like a really matte foundation on, so I like that a lot. And I have some highlighter on, so if you see shiny spots, that's that. It's not my oil or anything like that. So that's the starting point for the day. I will be doing updates throughout the day so you can see what my skin looks like throughout it. I do produce a lot of oil. If you watch my videos, you know that. So if you're like, you know, if by the end of the day I do have some oil, it doesn't mean that this product did not work. It doesn't mean that it did either, but I do produce a lot of oil. So if I produce less oil, I will tell you, even though it might not look like I produced less, but I might have. So just trust me on this one. So I'll see you in a couple hours with an update. Cross your fingers, I'll cross mine. Hopefully this product does what it says it will do, and I hope I like it because I spent $6 on it, darn it, and I want it to be good. All right, I'll see you in a couple hours. So as promised, I'm doing a quick update on my skin and my makeup and how the setting spray is doing. And without further ado, let me give you a closer look at what my skin looks like right now. Don't mind the pimples, because I do have a couple. As you can probably see, I am producing a little bit of oil, so the setting spray is not keeping me completely matte. However, I do produce a lot of oil on a daily basis, so I'm not sure if any product can actually keep me completely matte throughout the day. I am producing less oil than I typically would be at this point, though. I don't know if I can necessarily say that the setting spray is doing all of that, you know, work,
but I am producing less oil, so take it for what it's worth. And my makeup does not look cakey, which is awesome. I think it's lasting. I think it's looking good still, so I'm happy with that. I'll monitor my skin in the next couple hours though, and I'll do a final review, final summary of what I think about this setting spray, and hopefully I will still like it then. But I will see you in the
It's been about 6 hours since I first sprayed the NYX setting spray on, and now I'm gonna go ahead and do the final update and give you a closer look at my skin, what it's doing now, and just give you my final thoughts on this setting spray, and I guess setting sprays in general, because this is my first time using them. So number one is I am still oily. I'm still producing oil. It did not completely get rid of that aspect for me. Maybe for you it might, but for me it didn't necessarily stop my skin from producing oil. Maybe like a little bit, but you can still see I'm pretty shiny, so I don't think it really did anything in that department. However, I do think that this spray reduced the appearance of powder on my skin. I did have a lot of powder on me, or I still do, I guess, at that point. And at this point, I have a lot of powder on my skin, period. But when I sprayed this setting spray on, the powder almost kind of disappeared and melted into the skin, so it didn't have that powdery texture to it, which I don't think ever looks good. Even if you want that matte finish, I don't think you actually want like powdery look. You just want it to not be shiny or not look like this, basically. So I really like that aspect of it. Now, as far as the makeup lasting, I actually do think it creates a layer. I think this is what's going on. I'm not sure, but I think this is what's going on. It creates a layer on the skin that keeps the makeup together. It basically, it's like a mesh, not really a mesh, not like physical mesh, but like a chemical mesh that prevents your makeup from like moving and stuff, I think. And if that's what it's doing, or whatever it's doing in good, because I think the makeup is staying put on me. Let me give you a closer look at my skin. But unfortunately, this did not prevent me from producing oil. It's supposed to be a matte finish. I don't know if it's just implying that it's a matte finish in the beginning, or I think it's supposed to keep your skin matte. I think that's what it's saying it will do when I read matte finish. But at least it kept me matte in the beginning, but throughout the day it didn't really do anything as far as my oil production. Even though I do think I produce a little bit less oil, but I don't think I produced so little that I can say this does actually reduce the amount of oil that you're going to produce. So I think for $6 this is worth the try. I don't think it made my skin or my makeup cakey. I think that if anything it did something good for my makeup. It didn't actually do anything bad for it. As far as acne, I don't know if it will or will not cause me acne, because this is my first time trying it, so I'll have to see and keep using it, and I'll keep you updated. Maybe I'll do a little kind of an update in the description area when I do have any opinions on that subject or on that matter. But other than that, I think for $6 or however much this was, it was like $5 or $6, I think it's worth it. If you haven't tried a setting spray before and you want to, I think this is a pretty good one to try. Again, first experience with setting sprays, first experience with this specific setting spray, so I'm totally like new to this whole thing. If you have any setting spray recommendations, like your favorite ones, leave a comment down below. I'd love to try them out. I'm looking for new setting sprays to try out, because I think setting sprays are legit. I think they have a place in makeup routines. This is not like one of those products that a company is like trying to push you to buy so they can make more money, even though it actually doesn't do anything. So if you have any favorites, leave them down below. I'd love to see what they are. Other people that are watching this video might be able to use those comments and buy themselves some nice setting sprays. So thank you so much for watching my video. I really appreciate it. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more of my videos, subscribe down below. I left a sneaky little link down there in the description area. And I hope you found this video helpful, and thank you for watching, and I will see you later. And bye.